You may be choosing the wrong size of your brush when painting. I mean, maybe not, but I know I did, so check this out. So I was watching, I couldn't find it today because I don't remember exactly what artwork that was. I was watching one of the speed paintings, like the video recordings of the process by Ruan Jia. If you follow this channel, you guys know I'm a huge fanboy of Ruan Jia. It's my favorite Chinese artist. He's just a monster. I think it was like some kind of cyborg, and there were like cables going kind of like that, and then a shadow falling down from like the sun onto the stone. And instead of doing this for the cables, and then this for the shadow, and then trying to, you know, make it into more of a complex shape, to my surprise, he didn't do that. He immediately went, instead of choosing this size of the brush, he went with this size of the brush. And I was like, what's up with that? So he started just painting like that. And I was like, okay, that's an interesting approach. I literally never seen anyone painting an actual painting with this kind of, I don't know why it really struck me. And the shadow was even more interesting because it was a shadow fallen from these cables on the ground that is very like natural, crumbled, whatever, messy sort of stone. He just went ahead and was doing all the necessary details of those shapes right away. And I was looking at it just struck completely by the fact that how much it saves time. It lets you think with much higher definition right away. I felt like I was one of those characters from those TV ads when people in black and white were doing things wrong and there has to be a better way. And this is like the better way. So I started looking into the way Ruan Jia generally works on the details. It may sound unrealistic, but it's, for Ruan Jia, it's almost like a speed painting. Maybe it took like 5-6 hours tops. This is what his artworks look like when you zoom in, especially if it's like a quicker one. So pretty much when you look at this over here, you see the basic just search, some like bigger blocking in, like searching for the shape, for the composition. And then the moment he decided on everything, he just chooses a much smaller brush and just starts like doing this hatching drawing on top of his painting. He doesn't do that in between stage where we go like, okay, now a bit of a smaller brush, sort of trying to blend things together. He doesn't blend anything. He doesn't care about that. He just goes for the details right away. And that's exactly what's so striking about his artwork. This particular painting is very interesting because I actually found some other artists, and not to bash them or anything, they painted this copy of Ruan Jia's artwork way better than I would ever be able to paint it myself. One thing I noticed, like literally immediately, what's different is just how in here we can see this very striking, non-compromised definition of the tiniest details. If Ruan Jia is going for a tiny shadow, he defines little details of the geometry while at the same time defining amazing texture. So he doesn't limit himself to the shape of his brush, and he can literally so easily define such complex highlights and exactly the shape of little cracks, little variations on the values of the shape that he needs exactly without any compromise. Here's a screenshot. I don't know, I found it on the internet. He was working one of his huge paintings, and you can see how it's just a bunch of scribbles. But by the time he's done with a bigger long painting, this looks just unbelievably awesome. Having his shapes so three-dimensional and specific exactly because of that. Keep in mind though, like, it won't make amazing shapes, amazing geometry and anatomy and just visual library streaming out of your brush, but if you know the anatomy, you know what you're going for, maybe this approach will save you a lot of time and might push the level of your artwork a bit further, allowing you to show the textures and the precise geometry and shading that you may have struggled to show before. So that's something to think about. See you next time. Bye.